Hi everybody, Rob from State of Our Academy here. Today we're gonna learn something about scene organization. To help us about that, the best tool in 3ds Max is nowadays the Scene Explorer. From this software version, the 2015, the old layer tool is completely merged with the Scene Explorer. Let's see what we can do with it. First of all, the Scene Explorer let us manage the entire scene from a single panel. From the online guide, we can read Scene Explorer provides a modeless dialog for viewing, sorting, filtering, and selecting objects in 3ds Max, as well as additional functionalities for renaming, deleting, hiding, and freezing objects, creating and modifying object hierarchies, and editing object properties and masks. As you can see, I load a test scene with two windows made of frames, glasses, and handles. In the Scene Explorer, by default, we can see the layer list. The first layer is called 0 and is the default one. It's always there and we can delete it or rename it. We will use the layer 0 for groups. We add 3 more layers to keep objects with the same material together, and this way it's easier to select them. There's many ways to add an object to a layer. 1. You can select a layer and turn it into the active one. You will see the layer symbol turning blue, and then every object you will create will go into it. 2. If you already have the object in the scene, selecting it, you will see a blue background in the layer with that object inside. Just drag and drop the object from the list wherever you want. 3. If you already have the object in the scene, you can create a new layer with inside that object by clicking the Create New Layer button. We can rename a layer double-clicking on it. If we have a lot of objects and we want to rename them in one shot, we need to select them, right-click, rename, and then we choose something appropriate, leaving 3ds Max to finish. If you want to delete a layer, you need to delete its content before it. Basically, every non-active layer without the black arrow on the left is empty and could be deleted. The Scene Explorer let us play with settings of every object in the list. By default, we could freeze, unfreeze them, make them visible or not in the render, turn them into boxes to unload a lot of geometry from the viewport. From the Customize menu, the Configure Columns option let us add more controls to the Scene Explorer. For example, if we had faces, we will know how many polygons we have in every single object in the scene. We can hide layers or single object by clicking on the light icon on the left. As you can see, they will disappear from the viewport. If we need to hide a type of content from the Scene Explorer, we have to go in Customize, Toolbars, and enable the Display Toolbar. From here, you can simply hide what you want from the list to easily select other elements. Another way to see what you're looking for is searching it with the top input area. Completely different from the Manage Layer panel, the Manage by Hierarchy panel will show us relationship between objects. For example, in this scene we have two groups which contains all the Windows elements. If you select the group element and you move it, you will move all the child elements. Playing with hierarchy is basically like creating a parenting between objects. If I create two teapots and I drag and drop one of these into the other, the first will move both of them, but not the other way around. We are talking about simple movement relationships, but keep in mind there is a lot more to know about these, about wiring parameters or rigging. We will publish another tutorial about these really soon. Sometimes we need to select different objects during the workflow. Creating a group is not every time a good solution because we want to keep those objects separated. That's why we use name selection set. A name selection set is just a list of objects we can recall from a drop-down menu really fast. Imagine we need to select multiple times during the day work these teapot, these box, and these cone. After choosing them, we can write a name for the selection set and automatically 3ds Max will add it to the list. We can edit name selection set from here. We can create and delete set, add or subtract object from it, select all the childs of a set, open the Select by Name panel, and check if an object is actually inside a set. Remember, a name selection set is useful even if it contains just one object, probably because that object can easily be selected by clicking in the viewport. In 3ds Max, a group is a set of two or more objects. Once you group different objects together, the group itself will act like a single object. You can move, rotate, and scale it. You can add modifiers to it, and the group has its own pivot. We can even nest a group inside another group. To group together two or more objects, we need to select them and click on Group, Group. Now the group is closed, and we need to open it to select any of its content individually. So basically, there's pros and cons of groups. They are really handy when you want to keep together different pieces of geometry, but you need to remember to open them if you want to change something in the inside. Most of the time this happens when you assign new shaders. From the group menu, we can create and delete groups, open and close them, add or remove objects to them with attach-detach, and explode them, which means you will delete even nested groups in one click. Thank you.